Hjertelig velkommen sammen til Koncertkirken og til en lang dag med tidlig musik. European Day of Early Music 2015 is the third year we have this long day of events here in Koncertkirken. And as you probably know, all of you, it is a European day that is happening all over Europe at the same time. Not everybody has 8 concerts as we have in Copenhagen, but there's a lot of things going on at the same time, and many of these events are streamed online. The whole event is growing from year to year, and this year we have a new platform for streaming, which is inaugurated today. It's produced by REMA, the European Early Music Network, and it's actually a web radio for early music, which also hosts these kind of events. So the website is called remaradio.eu, and if you go online, you can find all the streaming concerts, both from here, but also from other places around Europe. So this is why we are streaming live now to the whole world. This is, of course, why I speak in English. So, as I said, we have 8 concerts coming up from now until midnight. And first out, we will start softly with a medieval concert with the Swedish group Laude Novella over here, Ute, Gödeke, and Per Mattsson. They have called the program Ave Donna Santissima, medieval music for Virgin Mary. Please welcome to Ute and Per.
Thank you. så mycket och thank you very much. I love to speak Swedish language in Denmark because I think we should understand each other more easily than we, well, some people think. We should speak our own language, but okay, let's go for English now then. We are very happy to be here today, and it's not only Johann Sebastian Bach that has a birthday today, also Virgin Mary has her day tomorrow, so therefore we choose some Maria music for this little concert. But we go on now with some Danish music in a drömde mig en dröm.
I dreamt a dream one night, which is the earliest secular music preserved in Scandinavia. It's a very small song, but still Danish. He is changing instrument.
I changed the instrument from a medieval fiddle to a tromba marina. Or in German, Trummscheit or Marientrompete. And maybe this tells more about the origin and the use of this seldom seen instrument. Maybe in monasteries, Marientrompete. And therefore, we choose to play a piece by Hildegard von Bingen.
Thank you. change of instrument from a very long violin pipe to a very short one, a very, well, square one. A violin machine called Sinfonia, an invention of the early medieval times. When would you say? 1200? Something like
later,
that.
Later.
A bit later?
We'll talk about it later.
We'll talk about it later. Sinfonia, and now a lauda for the Holy Mary, Holy Virgin, an instrumental piece, and another lauda.
Thank you.
Step forward in time to 15th century and the Lira d'Abruzzo. This is the, well, what happened before the violin. Yes, this happened. Okay. And the violin, the modern violin and the Lira d'Abruzzo, they existed parallel for 100 years ago. The reason why it's seldom heard is that we have only one piece written for this instrument in original, and it is this Romanesca. Thank you.
i håg mig, o heliga, o fromma jungfru. Kom ihåg mig, att jag inte må bli förtappad. Förtappad i denna eländiga och otröstliga värld.
Mange tak til Laude Novella, Ute Gøllinge. A very nice and soft start of the long day we have ahead. So again, thank you very much, Laude Novella, the Swedish medieval group. We have a short break now, so we start a new concert. We try to keep the schedule. We start sharp, 3 o'clock, with the next duo. We will be moving forward from medieval music to early Italian Baroque music. And Schäfel Hausam and Lena Langmalle will soon be on stage. In the break, the bar is open. We sell coffee and cakes, sandwiches, beverages, and so on. And we also have the CDs and magazines down there if you have a look. So welcome back in a few minutes.
Thank you. Was hast du gesagt?
Zwei Eins mit so Bällen, oder?
Thank you.
welcome back. That was a quick change. Lena Langbare and Schittel Hauptsand. And you, Peter. I think this is a new ensemble, is it? A new?
This doesn't look very new.
This is your first concert together?
Yes.
Okay, so we have it every year. So.
Well, not really. We did have one last year.
Okay, then she did last year.
I hope it is going to be as exciting for you as it is for us.
Yeah. So, please welcome Schittel and Lena. Early Italian Baroque.
Hjertelig velkommen. Jeg tillater meg å snakke litt norsk først. Etterpå skal vi spille, så da behøver vi ikke snakke. Men en venn av meg I Trondheim, han død nå dessverre. Han var en oppkomme, han var også musiker, var veldig interessert I tidmusikk og sånn. I sin tid, så han hadde ingenting å gjøre, for han var arkitekt. Så han hadde mye ledig fritid og sånn, så han satte sammen en sånn flott sånn compilation, sånn sammensetning, en dictionary, the New Devil's Dictionary of Music and Musicians. Og det var alt mulig rart, og det var til og med Bach, Bach organist from Germany, bla bla bla, also wrote some music and something. And then he wrote about Clemens non Papa, Flemish composer, who, unlike the Pope, had no children. Sånn var det. Det var ikke noe annet jeg ville si, altså. Men vi skal spille alt den her musikken, og men vi skal, dette her blir en veldig eksklusivt konsert, altså. Og det at vi spiller Frescobaldi og alt dette her, det jo veldig morsomt, da. Altså, we have less chance than a snowball in hell. We're sitting here in Copenhagen playing Italian music. Ha. Very privileged. Takk for at dere kom. Jeg håper dere får en fin time sammen med oss. For det veldig fin musikk dere får høre, altså. Thank you.
Kjetil Hagstrand and Lena Langbale from St. Cornetto for this wonderful Italian Baroque session. We have 10 minutes, full 10 minutes to the next concert, so please have a cup of coffee and restrooms downstairs if you need that. See you back here in 10 minutes. back to the main stage in Copenhagen, still streaming online live from Concertkirchen. We have a new duo soon on stage. It's the first concert here in Copenhagen. It's a non-Finnish duo. They used to be based in Helsinki for some reason, but actually we have a Canadian soprano, Debbie Wong, playing together with Solmund Nystabakt from Norway. And they won the competition, the Northern Early Music Competition in 2012. So it's a great honor to have you here in Copenhagen now, live on this European Day of Early Music. So please welcome to stage White Sparrow. Thank you.
And a very big thank you to our online viewers as well. We have people tuning in from Canada and Australia and all over Europe, so we're very excited that everyone can be here with us. Today we are exploring English melancholy, which was a very distinct thing in the late 16th and early 17th century. And the way our program works is that we start with sunset, when all the parties are coming to life. People are together, drinking, socializing, flirting, falling in love. And then we move further and further into the evening and the different stages of melancholy that might present themselves. So after the drinking and partying, we move later into the evening when forsaken love becomes known, or unrequited love, and the type of melancholy that might come with those feelings. And then we move further into the evening when the ideas of what who you are and what your life is might come to you, right, maybe right before bedtime, when you're sort of wondering, who am I? Where do I belong? What am I doing? And finally, we end with the deepest kind of melancholy, which comes always in the middle of the night when nobody else seems to be awake and you find yourself alone, and the kind of darkness that might come to mind at those times. And then we finish with a sweet lullaby. We're still in the happy part, though. We're still falling in love now. Thank you.
Thank you.